Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. If you use Column View in the Finder on your Mac, you're going to want to check out this new setting. So different people like to use different views in the Mac Finder. For instance, I like List View here because I could see all the items here with information in different columns, like the size, kind, date created, and so on. Others like Icon View, as it's user-friendly and allows you to organize things in two dimensions. But others like Column View. Column View is very useful in that you can view all the folders in one location, and then you can select one, and then you can see all its contents, and then you can select another folder inside of that, and so on, each one opening up in a different column. But you always have access to the levels above. So if I wanted to switch to this folder here, I can do it in one click like that to change my view to see the contents of that one. I can do the same thing with any folder here at any level. It's very easy to move around and also very easy to find a file and then decide you want to move it somewhere else by simply dragging it to a level above into a folder like that. But a thing people often complain about with Column View is the widths of the columns. So here you can see this first column is the perfect width for displaying the names of all of the folders. But if I select this folder here, I get a second column that's too narrow. You can see how some of the names here don't display. They've got these three dots in the middle and just the beginning and end of the name. In order to see the whole thing, you've got to drag the line to the right to widen the column. But if you switch to another folder like this, you could see this new column just takes the same width as the parent column here. And if you go back to this folder, you see you're back to actually seeing this column width. So it can get very frustrating always having to drag these to the right. You do have the ability to double click on the line like this, and it will snap to the perfect width for all of the content there. Also note that if in system settings, under appearance, you've got show scroll bars set to always, then you've got scroll bars here. You can't drag this at all or double click it, but you can use the small area to the bottom here to drag or double click, just like if it was a single line with show scroll bars turned off. So if you use Column View and you find yourself frustrated by how the column widths work, well, I've got good news for you, because starting in macOS Tahoe 26.1, there's a new setting, but you probably missed it because it's not in system settings and it's not in Finder settings either. It's in the view and then show view options controls. And here you're going to see different controls depending upon which view you're in. So for instance, here, if I was in icon view, you could see I get different options here. If I'm in list view, different options still, and column view gives you still different options. So you have to be in column view to see the options for column view. And the new setting here is at the bottom, and it's a checkbox called Resize Columns to Fit File Names. And if you check that, what's going to happen is the columns will always automatically resize to be that perfect width, the width you get if you double click on the line. So with that turned on, now let's take a look in this folder, and you could see this column opens up at the perfect width. If I click here, this one opens up with the perfect width, and so on. If I were to go to this folder here, I get a different width for the column because I've got some long items here. And if I go back here, it gives me the perfect width for this one. So you never have to resize the columns, but you still can. You can still grab a column and make it wider or narrower if you want. It will just snap back to the perfect width the next time you bring up that column. If you find these videos valuable, consider joining the more than 2,000 others that support MacMost through Patreon. You get exclusive content, course discounts, and more. You could read about it at macmost.com/Patreon. Now, one thing to note is that this setting is universal, as are a lot of the settings for column view. So just checking it here means that anytime you're in column view, it's always going to resize the column to fit file names. That's not necessarily true with a lot of the other view options, especially in list and icon view. Now, it's not perfect. For instance here, if I were to turn off show icons, You can see it doesn't need quite as much space, but it doesn't resize the columns here. Now, if I were to go to, say, another folder like this, another one, maybe go back here, and then turn on Show Icons, you could see it adds the icons back, but it doesn't resize the column width. So you end up with a few truncated names. But it's easy then to leave and come back, and then it forces the column to resize. I've even seen that happen when going to another folder. It doesn't get it right the first time, but then I go away and come back, and it gets it right. But it seems to work the vast majority of the time, and it's easy to correct when it doesn't. And it also has its limits. Like for instance here, I've got file names that are so long that hit some sort of limit and it won't go to the full size. I do have to stretch to the right or double click for it to get to that size. And if I go away and come back, you could see it does have that upper limit there. I've gotten tons of questions over the years from people that wanted to know how to have the columns automatically resized like this. So I know this is going to make a lot of people very happy. Hope you found this useful. Thanks for watching.